Sure, what fair to? Not really like that, Zidai.
The name is BOBO, pronounced Bobo.
Welcome back to Lucrapos.
Welcome to our mother's kitchen, where the magic happens. Peace.
So, if you're new to the channel, please subscribe, like, comment, hit that notification bell. So, we are the Lucrapos. We brew alcohol, we talk alcohol, homebrewed, we educate people about home brewing, and we show you steps on how to home brew.
Yeah.
With a ginger beer, wine, cider.
We do it all.
We do it all.
Liquor.
Liquor.
As long as liquor. It's liquor bro.
Yes. So today, Dinsa.
Yeah, man. Today, we've got some apple cider thing going on. We tasted our apple cider. Check out the video. Let us know what you think. And we liked it.
I'm going to link it here. Somewhere here.
Our patrons loved it.
Yeah.
And we're going to do it again. So we've got a sponsor who hooked us up with some apples. Some nice, fresh apples. And yeah, man. Going to do it. Take you step by steps. Today, we're going to wash, select, clean, and take out the core, freeze, and it's gonna get messy. It's really gonna get messy. So if you're planning to do a homebrew apple cider, dedicate some hours to it because it's really going to get messy and hands-on. Join us. Now, step one, we are going to wash our apples. We've got some hot water in there. We're gonna soak them, get them all nice and clean. Take out stuff like this. You see, stuff like this is gonna come out. Make sure your apples are nice and clean. What we don't want to have is an alcohol brew that's contaminated with a bacteria from not properly taking care of your apples. So take your time, wash your apples, make sure they are clean. Now here we are, our apples are nice and clean, as you can see, dripping water all over them. And you see some of them have been cut to make sure we get any blemishes that are undesirable out, just to be safe and you don't get any bacteria in there. So now, the next part, we're gonna take this little guy here. His name is an apple corer. We're gonna take him, we're gonna stick him right there in the center of the apple, push him right down, and voila! Apple with no core in it. So we're gonna do this, take out the core in all the apples so that when we get down to the grating and the mashing and the juicing of them, there's no seeds that are, you know, proceeded into our liquor by any mistake, or any seeds don't get grated into the liquor. So yeah, join us later on. Still have some 20 or so apples to decore, and we'll see you later. Sure. Decoring is done. Now what I'm gonna do is cut these babies into halves like so, and then bag them. Once the bag is full, we're gonna freeze this guy. Why are we freezing it? So that the ice can help us break down the flesh of the fruit better, right? So that we don't lose any flavors, nutrients, or any properties of the apple via boiling it. So we're gonna break it down with ice and then take it out, defrost it, let it come down to room temperature, grate it. After grating it, we're gonna sieve it and then we'll have our apple. So for now, cut them, bag them, tie it up, put them in the freezer. Join me again next week when we're done with the whole juicing process. Sure.